Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Musa alayhi salam runs for his life and he escapes Egypt. He was known as Prince Musa, living in a palace, top-notch food, security, education, and now he's very much homeless. He is hungry and barely has clothes to support him for the next few days. Allah knows best how it's ripped and torn throughout the traveling. He saw two ladies. He helped them with watering their cattle. But he knows something. He knows something, and we know something. That anytime you want, remember this, inshallah, طول حياتكم, inshallah, the rest of your life. Ready? He knows a fact. Never am I in a hardship about a specific case, and I help someone who has a similar hardship during my hardship, except that Allah will lift it off of me. Simple, yaakhi, shwe shwe. Okay. You're struggling financially? Yes. Oh, the bills. I'm telling you, give some of your money away fi sabilillah. La inta, you are nuts. No, this is an equation that you may not hear in school, in college, in your textbook, and so on, but we know in the Quran, in the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallam. Allah said, yunfiquna fi sarra'i, what's the other word? Wad-darra'. They give from their money, from their wealth, even during tight times, financial crises, they still give from what they have. And what does Allah give in return? More money. You want Allah to have mercy upon you? You want rahmah? Ana bidi an-nas tarhamni. You want rahmah? Yes. Have rahmah upon people. Give me proof. Allah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, irhamu man fil ardi, irhamukum man fil sama. Have mercy on those on earth, Allah will have mercy upon you. This is the way of life. So though Musa helped the ladies with the water, with the drink, with provision, he knows for a fact, I'm getting provision. But the question is not if he will get it, it's about when and how. That's the yaqeen and certainty. Oh, and the whole time you said the story, I thought he's such a nice guy, what mercy. Now it's all business. I help you, Allah to help me. No, why can I not do both? Yes or no? Why can I not do both? Yes or no? Some said about the Sahaba, they were tujar nawaya. They were business dealers with intentions. One of the Sahaba, he would see the time is tight. He made wudu. He comes to the masjid. So he comes to the masjid, he has wudu. He wants to pray two raka'at of wudu. The same two raka'at to be the welcoming of the masjid, tahiyyat al-masjid. The same two raka'at of sunnah such and such, and istikhara. Can they do that? Yes. So people say, why you want to go to Jannah? Because of the rivers, and because of the mansions, and because of the food. وَلَحْمِ طَيْرٍ مِمَّا يَشْتَهُونَ وَحُورٌ عِينَ, and all these things. I want all of this. So it's not for Allah. It's not for Allah. اتق الله. But where will I see Allah? Where will I see Allah? Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Where will we see Allah, inshaAllah? In Jannah. So I want to go to Jannah to see Allah and the other things as well. So here, when the person helps the other two ladies, Allah will reward them for that. So the question comes, what if that person did not think of the reward? Sah, that's the question. Like, what if I did not have a niyyah? What if Musa just went and helped them? Will Allah reward him? If I'm walking and my phone drops, the sister comes, picks it up. Will Allah reward her because he didn't say, I'm doing this for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, seeking his reward only, not for the sake of people's praise and a round of applause for that. No, no, it's for Allah. She didn't do this whole introduction. Will Allah reward her? That's when the ulama come in and they say, if someone does this action based on rahmah, based on good يعني, deed and a good niyyah, not for the sake of Allah, just like out of rahmah, out of love, out of care, Allah will reward them for that. If they were able to have a niyyah for Allah as well, then they get double the reward. So khayr and khayr, but it's double the khayr. So Musa alayhi salam does that. He goes under the shade of the tree, makes dua to Allah, anything you can give me will be great because I am so poor, faqir. Allah says in the Quran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. فجاءته إحداهما تمشي على استحياء. One of the two ladies eventually, when she went back home, the father was surprised. Why? You guys came early today. Usually they wait. What the two ladies said, when they all leave, we water our cattle. But you guys came early, before even the neighbors, you know. They said, yeah, there's a guy, Musa. So he told them what to do. Go ask him to come over. So Allah says in the Quran, so one of the two girls, she came. Allah says, tamshin, she's walking, ala istihya, upon modesty. And she's walking on the carpet of modesty. What does that mean? Everything about her is full of haya. Her dress code, full of haya. Her eye contact, full of haya. Her behavior, full of haya. The choice of words, full of haya. Allah Jalla Jalaluh praised her. So let's all have haya, men and women. Watch how we say, how we talk. Very professional. Haya. You know Rasulullah, when he says, every deen, every kullu deen, kullu al-adiyan, they have a symbol, a logo, a very famous character that represents them. وَخُلُقُ الْإِسْلَامِ الْحَيَاء. That's Islam, it's haya. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what did he say? إِنَّ مِمَّا أَدْرَكَ النَّاسُ مِنْ كَلَامِ النُّبُوَّةِ الْأُولَى إِذَا لَمْ تَسْتَحِي فَاصْنَعْ مَا شِئْتَ. If you don't have modesty, you don't have haya, then nothing will stop you from doing wrong things. Haya is like a defense mechanism. It's haya is usually connected to that which is wrong. In what sense? It's a protection. It's like an antivirus software, right? This is the haya that you have that protects you into falling. Some people's haya is more than others. They do extra steps to protect themselves. And don't you ever confuse haya with khajal or shyness that is inappropriate or wrong. How? A guy comes, he's at work, he's invited over for a party with alcohol at work, whatever, any of the big three companies or so, and he goes, and they're drinking khamr and alcohol, and he's in the midst of this gathering in a bar. You tell the brother, yakhi, why did you do that? Yakhi, wallah istahit. I had haya, I didn't wanna, they had a party with this guy, I didn't wanna embarrass him, and you know, like, I was just so shy. This is not haya. This is something else. Because haya, what did the Prophet ﷺ say about it? Remember this. Al-haya'u la ya'ti illa bi khayr. Haya never brings anything out of you except good. So if the thing that happened is bad, never use haya for it. Say anything. I was shy, مثلا في خجل, whatever the case is. Haya is always positive. Is that clear? Because though she had haya, this lady, she spoke to a guy. She was clear. One-on-one communication with him. Allah still said haya. And Rasulullah, he does not appreciate when someone tells someone else, reduce your haya. Don't go to that level. One time it happened. كان رجل يعظ أخاه من الأنصار في الحياة. One of the Sahaba. He's like, come on, man, don't have this level of haya, you know, the positive shyness. So when the Prophet heard that, he says, لا تعظوا في الحياة. Don't tell him to reduce. If that's his level of modesty, keep it as is. And I'll give you an example. You know the public washrooms, with all due respect. Many times you have, when someone goes to the toilet, may Allah protect you all, there's a space. Some people, I'm not saying it's haram to use public washrooms, relax. Breathe in, breathe out, okay? I'm in the car seat, the guy, remember the road trip? No. So some people, what do? They actually bring paper towel, a long one, to cover that small quarter of an inch. And who is gonna look through? But he's just an extra level of what? Say it. Haya. He does that. Don't say, yeah, don't go to that point. You see the difference? Al-haya'u la ya'ti illa bi khayr. So here the sister, she comes, and what does she want? She says, قَالَتْ إِنَّ أَبِي يَدْعُوكَ لِيَجْزِيَكَ أَجْرَ مَا سَقَيْتَ لَنَا. My father is inviting you to come over to the house to reward you, to appreciate the service you provided for us. It's a gift from my father. Please come. It's an invitation from him. Allahu Akbar. You see the response? Well, I didn't see the response. The response of what? Dua. This is, he's still probably sitting. And they come and they say, come, we're going to reward you. Allah, look at the barakah of the supporting people, helping people. May Allah make us at the service of people. Say ameen. For the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our dear brother Isa gave a khutbah today. May Allah bless him and accept from him. Say ameen. And reward his parents for this upbringing and keep him steadfast. Today he said in the khutbah, قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ إِنَّ أَحَبَّ النَّاسِ إِلَى اللَّهِ أَنْفَعُهُمْ لِلنَّاسِ. أَحَبُّ النَّاسِ, the most beloved people to Allah, are the ones who are most beneficial to the people. May Allah make us of them. Say ameen. So here, Musa alayhi salam gets the response of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through this lady, and he goes to the house. Now who he sees? The old man. فَلَمَّا جَاءَهُ وَقَصَّ عَلَيْهِ الْقَصَصِ. Musa, when he came, saw the attitude of the old man. Very respectful. He was a mu'min. He was a believer. Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah. Fantastic. So when he said, what's your story? Like, we've never seen you before. You look like you've been traveling. I told you, there's a sign, right? You've been traveling. What's the struggle? What's happening? Musa felt comfortable. And then he told him about his situation. And he told him the details, which I shared with you. I don't know how far, maybe more than what I obviously shared with you. I left Egypt. I'm running from my life. Pharaoh wants to kill me. I accidentally killed someone. 1, 2, and 3. And then at the end, فَالْقَالَ لَا تَخَفْ. The guy told him, the old man, don't be scared. You're good in this place. Remember, outside the territory of Egypt. Remember I told you that Midian is outside the ruling of Fir'aun? نَجَوْتَ مِنْ الْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ. You have been protected from the ظالمين. What did Musa make dua when he was in Egypt? رَبِّ نَجِّنِي مِنَ الْقَوْمِ الظَّالِمِينَ. And what did he hear now? Allah sent him, a human being, to tell him, Allah protected you from الظالمين. Why am I sharing this with you? Because Allah uses human beings to send you messages. بلشنا في الغاصفي now. What do you mean? Like, no. Listen. A sahabi went to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, Ya Rasulullah, a person does a deed for the sake of who? Allah. وَيَحْمَدُهُ النَّاسُ عَلَى ذَلِكَ. And then the people start thanking him, praising him, and so on. Is this wrong? Like, to feel happy about it? Because actually I get happy. Like, people said, good job. We thank you for your donations. It really helped us. You know what? Without Allah, then you, this institution would have collapsed. I feel happy. Does this ruin my reward? What does he say? لا تلك عاجل بشرى المؤمن. No, this is a hasty news Allah sends to the believer that he accepted your deed. Allah, may Allah make you hear that. Say ameen. So when you hear, ahsant. May Allah bless you. Ameen, Rabbil Alameen. So when this happens, I want you to be happy. When you get this praise, I want you to be happy. Not because so-and-so said great job. You're happy because is this a sign that Allah accepted? And you're busy that it's Allah, not the one who's telling you the point. Right? Allah says in the Quran about the awliya illah as-salihin, لَهُمُ الْبُشْرَى فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ. What's the bushra, the good news in dunya? Are the people's praise to you. May Allah grant it to all of us and keep us steadfast. Say ameen. So Musa, ameen, ya Rab. This guy's going to get all the du'a accepted, inshallah. Right? Ahsant. So then he said the story, the man accepted. Then one of the daughters, she tells her dad, Ya Abati, dad, استأجره. How about you hire him? إن خير من استأجرت القوي الأمين. Dad, I strongly encourage you, you know what? Hire him. Because the best employee to hire for this job of ours is someone of strength and someone who's trustworthy. This is the best HR advice of all time. Hire someone who is capable and is trustworthy. Sheikh Saud al-Shirim, may Allah bless him, he says, the times that we live in, there's a lot of people that have capabilities, but they lack trust. And there's some people who are trustworthy, but they just don't know how to work. Wallah, he's a nice guy, make him the president. He's a nice guy, ya Habibi, leader. Right? But not every leader is trustworthy. They know how to lead. They're amazing. How many people are great at accounting and so on? But how will you use it? Are you Amin? So she said he has both. Now the question I have for the sister, how did you know he has both? How does she know he's strong? He's traveling for Allah knows how long. Now, after especially I heard the story, he came from Egypt, guys. Now she heard the deed, like she knew he's traveling. Now she knew from how far he came and how he came. And still he had the physical strength to go with the cattle, water them. And remember the rock I told you? The rock 7 to 10 people carry. He carried it by himself. Qawi. And how did she know that he's Amin, trustworthy? How? Multiple ways. Of them is the fact that he returned the cattle back. The fact that he could have abused the situation. Two ladies, tadudan, they're far away. No one is really caring about them. Because if they did, they would have told them ladies first. So with all of this, he still gave us back every single sheep. There were 10, he gave us back 10. And not just that. The way he looked at us. The way he spoke to us. The way he communicated with us. There was no unnecessary speech. There's no unnecessary flirtation or any words that are outside the professional aspect. He was Amin. We told him, our dad is an old man. So in general, we look like we're at a position that we may seem weak, but he never abused that. Ameen, Allahu Akbar. That's why, with all due respect to brothers and sisters, I say, a man who communicates with a woman outside the boundaries of Islam is not someone to be fully trusted. I learned it from my sister in the Quran. A man who communicates with a woman outside the boundaries of Islam is not someone to be fully trusted. May Allah guide him and us and forgive us all. Say ameen. Oh no, there's two. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. All right, so I'll stop making dua. No, in the khayra man ista'jarta al-qawiyyul ameen. So here, brothers and sisters, now what happens? The father is a smart man. Why? He notices two things. He's a smart man by noticing that indeed you're right, he is someone worthy to hire. But also, he is someone worthy for marriage. Now, undivided attention. Let me see if you say ameen at this age. Okay? All right? Okay. So the point being here, Musa alayhi salam is, طبعاً, he's not really hearing all these details. Allah knows best, yani. So how will this genius father be able, because he felt his daughter respectfully, indirectly requesting that he's suitable also for marriage. But the father knows, all right? And he knows he's really well. So he goes, how will he be able to get both? How can he get Musa to be an employee and also be a son-in-law? Look what he says. He goes to Musa alayhi salam, قال إني أريد أن أنكحك إحدى بناتي هاتين. One of my daughters, I'm looking to get married, and would like to ask for your hand for my daughter. And there's nothing wrong with this. Nothing wrong with the father noticing a very righteous man, a very righteous brother, and Allah knows the hearts, to go and tell him, would you be interested in my daughter? طبعاً, maybe in some areas, it's like, are you majnoon? Right? ساحر أو majnoon, right? No, who did this? Umar ibn al-Khattab, radiallahu anhu, the hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari. Sorry. What happened? His daughter Hafsa radiallahu anha, she lost her husband. So Umar al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, now he's looking for an appropriate man for his daughter. It was not like, let's wait, inshallah, yiji ibn al-halal or whatever statements that we say. No, sometimes you go for the ibn al-halal. He says, tam bi adab wa hikmah. Okay, watch who you go to, right? And then Umar al-Khattab goes to who? Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu. He says, ya Uthman, you know my daughter Hafsa, she lost her husband, and we will be honored and very happy if you were to accept marrying my daughter. طبعاً, Hafsa, of course, on the same page as her dad. طبعاً. Uthman, he said, let me think about it. Uthman thinks about it. He comes back. He says, not now. Not ready. No problem. So Umar al-Khattab goes to Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. He says, ya Abu Bakr, you know my daughter Hafsa, she lost her husband. We'll be very honored and happy if you marry Hafsa. And you know what I like? Who's better, Abu Bakr or Uthman? Non-negotiable, Abu Bakr Siddiq. Non-negotiable. I like how he did not downgrade. Did you see that? He said, wallah, you know what? Shabab ta'abana, at'ab wahad. You know what I mean? Like all miserable people. Who cares? Just accept anything. La. Uthman said, no, I'm going to go for Abu Bakr. Allahu Akbar. So he goes to Abu Bakr Siddiq. Abu Bakr Siddiq does not even reply back. Yeah, this is bad. Like, for those who know, no. This hurts. Right? So then, Umar Khattab, wajada fi nafsi, like he got hurt, like, Abu Bakr Siddiq, I told you, would you be interested in my daughter? He heard that, he never got back to me, never called me, never came day two, day three, but what happens? Someone comes, and the proposal comes from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He wants to marry Hafsa. That's why Hafsa is the mother of the believers, Umul Mu'mineen. So then who comes? Abu Bakr Siddiq. Khair. Right? So he goes to Umar. He says, ya Umar, you remember when you told me about your daughter Hafsa? He's like, yes. Wajadta fi nafsik? Didn't appreciate that? He's like, at all. Umar is an insan, radiallahu anhu. He says, ya Umar, wallahi, if it wasn't that Rasulullah told me already that he's interested in your daughter, I already know, when he came to me, I already knew Muhammad wants to propose to your daughter, I would have been honored to say yes. But I knew Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wanted her, so obviously I left it to him. And also, you have to appreciate the amana, right? Like, how was he able to hold the secret? How? Like, how was he able to keep a straight face? Oh, you want me to marry Hafsa? Not me, but someone better is coming. And we give so many details. Something special coming. طب who's Abu Bakr Siddiq? بس واحد. If someone better, there's only one. Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. So the Sahaba were able to maintain al-amana fi sir. A secret was given with Abu Bakr Siddiq, yadal. No hints, no indications, no signs. So then Musa alayhi salam, he hears the proposal. He says, my proposal is this. Would you be interested in marrying my daughter? And under the condition, fi shart, what's the condition? That you work for me in a contract for 8 years. Ala thamaniya hijaj. We have a contract in the aqd al-zawaj, the marriage contract, like the dowry or the mahar or a condition, is that you work for 8 years for me. Yeah, this is like a dream come true, shabab, wallah. Right? Like you don't have to apply for jobs. Everything is like handled. And then the father says, I got you. You get to marry my daughter. I get to give you a job. His job security, Allahu A'lam, is better than all of us here, I think. Right? Some of us are like, I don't know, wallah, there's some laying off in Ford. I don't know if I'll make it till next year. He has 8 year contract. Then he says, if you want, then he says, if you want, atmamta ashran, like you can extend 2 years. You know, like they say, like in athletes, you got 8 year contract and a 2 year player option. They get to choose if you want to transfer somewhere else. But we can guarantee you 10 years, but at least 8 you have to stay here. وَمَا أُرِيدُ أَنْ أَشُقَّ عَلَيْكَ. I don't want to make things hard on you. سَتَجِدُونِ إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. You'll find me a very reasonable man. I will not overwork you. What will Musa say? How will Musa respond? This is a dream come true. And I put water, remember? I gave water. I lifted the hardship. Gave them water. Allah now is giving me a wonderful family, a righteous wife, a job, house. Yeah, this is a dream come true. But will Musa accept being a shepherd, guys? And Musa, Amir Musa, he could ra'i ghanam. There's nothing wrong with that. And he accepted. I will be a shepherd. I will take care of the sheep. I will do that. No problem. So that's, I want to advise this, because I remember I spoke to one brother, good brother, mashallah, tabarakallah. He has degrees and certificates and so on, and he had a good job. But he ended up moving, and he was actually a refugee when we were in Canada. He moved and he says, anything less, back in the day, I'm talking really long time ago, anything less than $20 an hour, I'm not working. But you're actually just depending on the government completely. And the sunnah of Rasulullah is that you should to go, وَالْكَسِبْ مِنْ عَمِلِ يَدِكْ, that you earn from your own hand. So don't be that type of person, is that if I don't get such a job, I will never work. La. Be like Musa alayhi salam. I was an Amir one day, but if I lost my job and this what's available, I'm gonna do that job. Can we do that inshallah? Act like men bi'ithnillah. Dawood alayhi salam was a malik, a king, and barely any prophet was a king. Though he was a king, he used to still work with what? With iron, wa hadid, wa kana haddadan, Dawood alayhi salam. So then Musa alayhi salam, he hears this. He said, yes, ذَلِكَ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنِكَ. I agree, I approve of this. أَيَّمَ الْأَجَلَيْنِ قَضَيْتُ فَلَا عُدْوَانَ عَلَيْهِ. He's actually repeating the conditions. So I will do either of the two, either 8 years or 10 years. If I don't do 10 years, there's nothing wrong against me. 8 years is my minimum, I'm down for that. وَاللَّهُ عَلَى مَا نَقُولُ وَكِيلٌ. Allah's watching. I don't know why I feel I'm doing this, وَفِي زَغْرُوتَ is coming after that, right? Like mabruk, congratulations, wa hafla, wa party. Allahumma barik, Allahumma barik. Musa alayhi salam works as a shepherd. Alhamdulillah. Ash-shughl, as they say, mish'ayb, right? There's nothing wrong with halal income. He's having a family, wonderful wife, contemplating the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Obviously, he misses his mom, his brother Harun, his sister Maryam. And of course, he misses who? Asiya radiallahu anha, the one who raised him. And surely she's very concerned about him. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, years have passed. فَلَمَّا قَضَى مُوسَى الْأَجَلِ. When Musa alayhi salam ended that term, how many? 8 or 10. We have a hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, just out of curiosity, and not, no wrong answer. Who thinks he did 8 years only? Who here thinks he did 10 years? Naam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he asked Jibreel, he said, سَأَلْتُ جِبْرِيلِ أَيَّ الْأَجَلَيْنِ قَضَى مُوسَى. He says, أَكْمَلَهَا وَأَتَمَّهَا. He says, the one that is, atamahuma, he did the one that is full with the 10 years. So this is from the generosity, of course, and the kindness of Musa alayhi salam. He really, really, really wants to go see his family in any way possible. 10 years almost has passed. I will do whatever is necessary to pass by Egypt somehow, maybe send a note or something. Then Allah says in the Quran, wasara bi ahli. He finished the decade of work. He left with his wife traveling, As he was traveling, very dark area, أَنَسَ مِنْ جَانِبِ الطُّورِ نَارًا. He saw fire next to a mountain, Al-Tur. When he saw the fire, he told his family, أُمْكُثُ, for his wife, his family, stay here. إِنِّي أَنَسْتُ نَارًا. I saw a fire from there. لَعَلِّي آتِيكُم مِّنْهَا بِخَبَرٍ. Perhaps I can go there, get some guidance on the way, just making sure we are on the right path to see my family and so on and so forth. أَوْ جَذْوَةٍ مِّنَ النَّارِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَصْطَلُونَ. Or at least, if the guy don't know the directions, I can go get some fire or some hatab and so on and some wood and warm ourselves a little bit in the cold desert. When Musa alayhi salam was walking and he left his family behind, he arrived. فَلَمَّا آتَاهَا. There was no one. ما في إنسان. ولا حيوان. ولا animal. Human, nothing, absolutely nothing. No one. This is strange. This is weird. What's going on? It's very peaceful. Serenity. طمأنينة. The feeling is unexplainable. All of a sudden, he hears his name being called. Ya Musa. He can't see. What was this? Ya Musa. Ya Musa. Inni anallahu rabbul alameen. Inni anallahu al-azizul hakeem. Wa ana akhtartuk fastami' lima yuha. You are the chosen one. I am your Lord, the Lord of all beings. You have been chosen. So pay attention to what I'm about to tell you. What will Allah tell Musa? What are the details? How is he feeling with this? What's the mission? All of this, inshallah, November 19th, on a Friday, here bi-ibnillah. Jazakumullahu khairan. Wassalamu alaikum.